Hello and welcome to the second small. This is the second meetup of the Krakow startup community. We call ourselves Hive. We're happy to see you all here and to see that so many of you showed up today, even though the weather is kind of gray. I think we'll start, like we did last time, with a little show of hands to get the feel of who comes to our meetings. So the first question is, who here works in a startup? So please raise your hand if you work in a startup. Okay, quite a few. Do we have any students here?
Yes.
If you're a student, please raise your hand. Come on, this is not the time to be shy. Okay, last question is, who was here last time, almost a month ago? Okay, quite a few. I guess, well, it makes us happy that so many of you thought that it was a nice idea enough to come again. We'll try to keep improving those meetings so that you get more and more out of them. We have a great guest today, but before we get to that, we'd like to start with a kind of a new position on the agenda, which is the session with the elevator pitches. Elevator pitch is basically, if you're a young entrepreneur, quite often you need to describe your idea in a very short period of time. Like the theme is that you have 60 seconds and you're in an elevator with an investor and you need to convince him that your idea is great and that you're going to change the world. So it's a good thing to even do it as a kind of, you know, it's so often that you need to do it, you need to practice it. So. I know we have a few people that would like to pitch today, but kind of warm up. I think I'll do my own pitch first. So the rules of the pitch are that we have no slides. There's a maximum of 60 seconds, so you need to be short and brief and get the point across very fast. Can I start now?
Yeah, you can start now.
Okay, good. Well, I'm sure that most of you here spend quite a lot of time online. I'm online almost all the time. And have you ever had this problem that that you wanted to go back to a page that you once visited in the past, but you didn't quite remember the address, or that you keep, or do you keep multiple tabs open in your browser just because you have no easy way to go back to them? Well, I struggle with these problems every day, and to me they are a huge time waste and an energy drain. So this is why I'm creating Godot. Godot is the spotlight for your web history. It basically listens to everything or reads everything you read online and saves it and makes it easily accessible to you through search on all of your PCs. It's going to be a free service with premium paid features. It's not ready yet, but go to godot.com and follow us. One thing I'd like to add is that I'm looking for a co-founder.
I'm the founder and lead developer of Apocalypse Online, which is a practice-based startup. And we're going to create an to create broader
bases
and to allow us to create more games in the future and work on these applications.
Move the microphone.
All the work started in early 2010. And it was about two or three people then working on the project. Now we have 10 people, and 2 months ago we have released an early alpha version. From last month we were working hard.
My name is Simon. We're here to present to our daily project. It's nicewide.pl. Nicewide.pl is an internet service which presents the best second-hand vehicle announcements on the web. Our weekend experts choose different cars, one per day, and they comment the announcements and they give advice about the cars. We don't sell the cars, we don't share photos, content, or we don't tell the exact price of the announcement. Our strengths. low cost is a unique idea. We've got wide car market knowledge. We've got mobilization program under implementation and practical plans of development for future. Our achievements. Until now, we started 2 months ago and we've got 130 funds.
Yeah, and we're just out of time.
My name is Dominic, I'm a designer. This is not a startup, but this is a project and a solution to a problem I've been having for the past 7 years. Basic problem was that I couldn't find one source for local events happening in the city. So I've been using this project that I've created for some time now, and I decided today to release it to the public. So I invite you to visit the kiedy.co on your browser. That's kiedy.co, which in Polish means what? Not when.
Okay, hello everybody. My name is Marek. This is Jacek. We'd like to tell you about our third and new project Omnigo. Omnigo is a place where you can publish your articles, share knowledge, and create conversations. Completely for free, and this is not the end of the story.
Yes, our goal is creativity, and we want to make a new quality for all internet users. Our users can write their articles and earn money from the ads and partnership programs displayed next to their articles. They can compose their articles from different kinds of paragraphs, like text, images, YouTube movies, links to the Skompiets or Allegro pages. They can also make polls and add comments.
Omnigo is easy to use and fully integrated with Facebook. You can log into Omnigo using your Facebook account. You can also share directly to Facebook wall to attract potential readers with just one click.
We encourage all of you to join Omnigo today and start your adventure.
Hi, I'm Mark Rudolph, and I found out about 10 minutes ago that I was about to do this pitch. But if any of you have ever been looking for market research and market forecasts, you know that sometimes it can be quite expensive if you go to Gartner or IDC or some of these companies. So imagine a Wikipedia, but for market research and forecasts. A collaborative approach to bringing the data together and the analysis together for a low cost or free, so you can approach a much broader audience. Right now it's a concept. I've got one other potential partner involved, looking for some other people who just like the idea and want to contribute to it. Thanks very much.